So let's see how we can solve this equation with inverse tangent. And this equation is from the Precalculus textbook by James Stewart. In fact, it's from the scale plus section, so it's meant to be more difficult than the usual equations. Here we have inverse tangent of x plus inverse tangent of 2x. It's equal to pi over 4. How do we even deal with this? Right, we have two inverse tangents. So this is the difficult part. We have to know that the result of an inverse trig function represents an angle. So this is an angle, and this is also going to be an angle. Okay, so two angles add up to pi over 4. What's the best way to do this? Well, let's use the original tangent. But do it carefully though. I'm going to just write out another line for you guys. I'm going to apply the original tangent right here. So this is the first angle, and then we have another angle here. And then that is equal to, of course, we take the we take the original tangent, both sides. So it's like this. This is easy, it's just one. That, what is it though? Well, we have to use the formula. So here we go. Okay, so here's the deal. If we have tangent, and let's say we have an angle sum, right? So tangent of A plus B, this right here can be derived from looking at this by sine A plus B over cosine of A plus B, and then simplify it a little bit. I'm going to leave that to you guys, or maybe check on my other video for it, but I will tell you the result. It will be tangent A plus tangent B over 1, and here it's a minus, and then here is multiplication. Tangent A times tangent B. How do I know that? It's right here. So I'm just going to apply this formula with this right here being the A and this right here being the B. And of course, now we have the tangent of inverse tangent, they can legitimately cancel. I'm going to write down all the steps for you guys. So here, we will get original tangent of our A, which is inverse tangent of x. And then we add original tangent of inverse tangent of 2x, which is the B right here. And then all over 1 minus tangent of inverse tangent of x times tangent of inverse tangent of 2x. And the right hand side is equal to 1. And now here comes the best part. Original tangent, inverse tangent cancel. This is true for all x. This is true for all x. So there's nothing too much we have to worry about, because the domain for inverse tangent is from negative infinity to positive infinity. So here though, we have x. Plus, here though, we have 2x. Over, this is just 1, and that's a minus. Here we have, you know, this and that cancel, we have the x. Times 2x. And that's equal to 1. And now we get the following. This is just 1 minus 2x squared. So I'm just going to multiply both sides by 1 minus 2x squared, so that this and that cancel. So we get the following. Okay, so here we have 3x. And that's equal to this times that, which is 1 minus 2x squared. And now we get a quadratic equation. I will put these two things to the other side. So positive 2x squared plus 3x, and then minus 1, that's equal to 0. And that's just the quadratic formula. X equals negative 3 plus or minus square root of 3 squared, I don't have enough space. Negative 1. And then all over 2 times 2. Yes. All right, now let's finish it. X is equal to negative 3 plus or minus square root. This is 9. 4 times 2 times 1 is 8. Negative times negative is plus. So 9 plus 8, which is 17, all over 4. Done. No, not yet. Okay, so right here, only one of them is going to work. Which one? I'll tell you. The positive version. So we're going to get rid of the negative right here. And this is the reason why. we will have to pay attention to the domain range for inverse tangent. And the most important thing right here is the following. Note that if you have the inverse tangent of x, the output of it is in between of negative pi over 2 and pi over 2, not including the endpoints. And the truth is, if you have negative x value, you will get negative output. So if we put a negative here, the whole thing is negative. If you put that into x here, the whole thing will be negative. Likewise, this part will also be negative. Negative plus a negative, you cannot get positive pi over 4. So therefore, the only possible answer for this right here is x is equal to negative 3 plus square root of 17 over 4. This is the only answer. That's it.